Hello everyone, welcome to your channel Pharmacypedia. This is Dr. Shikha Chauhan and in this session I'm going to discuss you a topic from the subject Social and Preventive Pharmacy, BPharm 8th semester, and the topic is about the poverty and the health. So how poverty and health are related to each other, that we are going to discuss in detail. Since the subject Social and Preventive Pharmacy talks about the disease, social implications, prevention. So one needs to understand how the health is related to different parameters of social life. So this comes under the purview of the community pharmacy. So my dear students, without wasting the time, let us begin. But if you have still not subscribed to my channel Pharmacypedia, please do like, share and subscribe to my channel Pharmacypedia for getting further updates and important informations related to pharmacy. So let us begin. So let us first try to understand about the poverty. What is poverty? All of us know that poverty is lack of your financial expenses. It is a condition, it is a state whereby the economical status of any person is compared and is related to richness. Richness and poverty are opposite to each other. So the topic is a very sensitive topic relating to your poverty with the health issues. We know many people have the different segments. Some belong to poor, some belong to middle class, some belong to the rich class. Now how this social status affects your health in overall, that is again very important to understand. So the poor, who are those below the poverty line, refers to the BPL in India. So poverty impedes means hinders the progress and all factors of human life, whether it is related to housing, sanitation, getting healthcare services, dietary intake, etc. So when a person is poor, he can't afford to have a big house, and if the person lives in the cluster, definitely health gets impacted. Similarly is the water contamination, sanitation, hygiene related to your housing conditions. Then moreover, getting frequent healthcare services, getting important health analysis done becomes difficult with the poverty sector. Then dietary intake is also indirectly related to the economical status as well. With the growing issues associated, it becomes difficult to have the benefits of having the good diet. Overall results in the increased in the morbidity and the mortality. Now what are the causes of poverty? One needs to understand in detail. There are many issues related to that. First is the rapid population growth among the poor. Due to non-acceptance of the family planning methods, it results in the population explosion. So you must have seen that among the poor people, due to low acceptance of the family planning techniques, it results in the population growth at an alarming rate, which further increases the problem. After that comes the low rate of economic development. With the growing economy, with the growing population, it becomes difficult for them to survive and to have a healthy and sustainable life. Then the problem of unemployment also results in poverty. Then the poor growth strategy. Inequalities of the income. Different segment of the people have different inequalities in terms of the income, that again also give rise to the poverty. Then little trickle down effect of the economic development. Backwardness of agriculture, inadequate anti-power measures, low education. Now this is again very important here to understand that the education impacts the social economic status a lot. The people who are totally illiterate, they find it difficult to survive on their own. Then inflation rise in the prices. Now you must have seen that inflation has got a lot increase in past few years. So again it becomes difficult for the people who are below the poverty line to lead a very healthy and very sustainable developments. Then social cultural factors. In India, we have different segments ranging from North India, South India, and we have different variations in the cultural. Now this cultural background also impacts the health, also impacts the socioeconomic status. Then certain political factors also influences. They make the laws in such a way that it is benefiting the rich and not benefiting the poor. So certain political factors also give rise to the poverty conditions. Now, how do we measure this socio-economic status? So it is basically based on three variables. The first is the education, second is the occupation, and third is the income. So to measure the socio-economic status, these three factors have taken into consideration: education, occupation means profession, and your income. So there are three methods which have been devised to measure the socio-economic status. Now they are based by the scientists, those who worked on that. The first is the B.G. Prasad's method, then Kuppaswamy method, then third Parikh's method. Now let us try to understand the below poverty line category in India. So it is defined as a cutoff line of per capita monthly income below which it is not possible to purchase the food and as to obtain the minimum desirable limit of energy. So minimum desirable limit of energy is 2400 kilocalories per person per day in rural areas and 2100 kilocalories in urban areas. So this is the official definition for the people who are leading the life below the poverty line. So if they are not able to afford the food, these minimum calories respective to the rural and the urban area, they are being categorized as the BPL. Then they fall below the class 5 according to B.G. Prasad's category. Now poverty is also related with social factors. What social factors? Now there are certain social wrong trends going in the society. For example, low education. For example, not providing education to the girls, totally ignorance, not able to have the wide horizon, broad horizon, then lack of knowledge in of certain areas. For example, lack of knowledge of cleanliness, sanitation, hygiene also have a lot of impact. Then poor living condition, overcrowding, and blind beliefs and taboos. You must have seen that people who are illiterate are more prone to accept the blind beliefs and taboos existing in the societies. Now how the poverty is related to the health hazards. Now if we talk about the poverty, you can now understand it is related to poor education, poor sanitation, poor hygiene, poor person, it's difficult for him to afford the food. So like the people who are lying into this category are more prone for the waterborne disease, foodborne disease, respiratory disease, STIs including HIV. So the communicable disease. But why? Because they are living in clusters, the population is high, so they are more prone for these disease. Then talking about non-communicable disease, you can understand they are all food related. For example, malnutrition. What is malnutrition? Malnutrition is undernutrition. The person is lacking the minimum requirements for the proteins, which if not provided for long run results in the protein deficiencies, anemias, vitamin deficiencies, mineral deficiencies. Now, what are the health hazards? Further discussing about the social problems. So this was about the food related problems or like education problems. Now comes the social problems. Now there are various social evils which even today exist in our society, like prostitution, drug addiction, alcoholism, family disintegration, antisocial behavior, certain tendencies like beggary, violence, delinquency, terrorism. So because of these social problems, they are most influenced by these people living the life of poverty, and because of that again give rise to the health hazards. Further, we have discussed about the communicable disease, non-communicable disease, and moreover the other determinants like economic stability, social and community context, neighborhood and the environment. Any people living in any housing society is much impacted by the neighborhood and the environment. Then healthcare facilities existing at that particular location again also impacts the people living the poverty life. Now, health hazards are the people. You will be amazed to know that people living in most of the deprived 10% of areas will die 9 years younger than those living in the richest. So this is the research data which clearly shows that people leading a healthy life is related to their socioeconomic status. Then again, certain mental problems like poor people are also more accessible to mental problems like depression, loneliness, inferiority complex, suicidal tendencies are more in such cases. And other problems like scabies, dental caries, because they are all related to your hygiene, oral hygiene, your living hygiene. So this again results in health hazards if not taken care of on a prolonged period basis. Now, how one can overcome the problem of poverty in India? The Indian government has provided many facilities, many schemes to help the people below the poverty line. So BPL people are recognized by their yellow cards. You can see on the left hand side the image of that yellow card. Then apart from that, several government schemes like Janani Suraksha Yojana for pregnant mother aged 19 years and above, National Maternity Benefit Schemes. So it provides a better diet for the pregnant women so that a child born does not suffer from malnutrition and other disease, insurance of the women workers, Bhagya Lakshmi scheme, so social assistance like for the people belonging to the old age, and much more family benefit schemes like widow pension scheme, Prasuti Araike, promote antenatal care. So there are certain schemes benefiting the pregnant women and poor people and old age people to have a better life. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please do provide your comments in the comment section if you find anything related to poverty and healthcare. Also, please do like, share and subscribe to my channel Pharmacy PDF for getting further information about the social and preventive pharmacy. Thank you so much, everyone.